Hey, 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 it's a beautiful day to talk about why you matter. Hi, I'm Sale, if you don't know me, and if you do know me, this video is definitely going to be different than what I normally post on my channel. I'm putting it out there now, if you're sensitive to topics like suicide, depression, kind of mental illness in its whole, I advise you click out of this video now, so please watch at your own risk. As a former Barrie Creek student and as someone who has attempted suicide, lost friends and family to suicide, and saved people moments before they could have been successful with suicide, I felt like I wanted to make a video to show the impact this action can take. If you didn't know, and hence the poppy I'm wearing, today marks the 1 month since Barrie Creek lost their second student in 3 months to suicide. I wanted to start this video off with giving my little introduction and then showing a video I made in May for my dance class before I graduated that my theme actually revolved around suicide and the fight that it takes to overcome the thoughts that anyone may be having. Following that, I have some individuals that I'm very thankful for who either sent me videos or gave me a quote that they wanted to include in this to talk about how they've been affected from people they've lost. Those individuals include Michaela Parsons, Michaela Rower, and Ethan DeClark.
Hi, my name is Chelsea and I'm 20 years old. I've attempted suicide about 5 times throughout my life. And I think the main signs y'all should watch out for include seeing your friend or someone you know dig themselves into a deeper isolation, as well as lethargy and exhaustion and them not being interested in the same things that they used to be interested in or less passionate about the things that they were passionate about. And yeah, if you do notice that, please reach out to that person, to that friend. And if you're that person that's feeling suicidal, don't do it. I can tell you right now, it sucks in the meantime, but it does get better. So just reach out for help. Look out for each other, love each other. Take care.
I follow you into the park, through the jungle, through the dark. Girl, I never loved one like you. But walls and boats and waterfalls, alleyways and payphone calls. I'll be here never out with you. We laugh until we think we'll die, barefoot on a summer night. Nothing new is sweeter than we.
Hi, I'm Jade, and I just want to talk a little bit about Ethan. Ethan was a student at Bay Creek who did commit suicide over the summer. Ethan and I used to play volleyball together, and his nickname was Lib. We called him Lib because he would always play the libero position, which was a really hard position, and he would put everything he had into it. And that way he practiced every single day. He put everything he had into volleyball. People who are usually depressed, the signs that you would think is lack of motivation and etc., all that type of stuff, but he didn't show that. I thought he was happy, and that just goes to show that people who are happy aren't always not in pain. They need support too. They need to have a shoulder to cry on as well. So check on the ones who also seem like they're okay.
The world is grim. Some of us have it better than others, but the truth is, we all struggle. Some of us are born with it, some of us develop over time. Some of us deal with it easily, and some of us don't make it to the end. I could go on forever listing my struggles and the things I've watched other people deal with, but that's exactly the problem. In the present time, we are so consumed with the things that make our lives miserable that we don't have the room to think about the things that make us forget about the misery. I do not know for sure, but I could imagine that if you walked down the street and asked a person at random, "What do you like about your life?" they could riddle an ambience of things that they had pre-written, scripted, prepared for any given moment. And if you asked the same person, "What do you like about your life?" I feel like the list would be either much shorter or only come out after a moment of thinking. Some of us cannot look at the past negatively. It takes over, and all of a sudden, there is nothing good. Nothing to look forward to. But the thing is, there is so much we haven't yet to experience. People that love us, who we haven't met yet. Movies with our favorite actors we have yet to watch. Jokes that haven't been told. Music that hasn't been listened to. Beauty in a miserable world that has yet to be found. When you think about it, there is so much to look forward to. So many things that would manage to make us forget the pain that we've experienced as if they never happened. This doesn't mean we don't fall down from time to time, but there will be enough to get us back up. To anyone who has ever had the thought of stopping their life in its tracks cross their mind, I tell you this. It's hard to look past all the pain and suffering you've experienced. That much is true. And it's even harder to find the light when your world seems so dark. It is so worth the fight to find it. Things will not get better unless you want them to. And that is exactly what you have to do. You have to fight every day. It won't be an easy fight, but the end result will thank your past for finding the courage to do so. It takes time, though. Rome was not built in a day. It wasn't built in two either. The work is not pretty, but if you want it, that's exactly what you have to do. You have to fight.
Together a video about mental health and awareness. But I thought I'd be able to be a little bit stronger, but anyways, please always look for signs. I unfortunately never had any signs. So when I came home from work one day, I was expecting to make dinner for my children, and instead I found my daughter. 2.5 years. And every day doesn't get any easier. I'm gonna show you what I get to look at every day. This is my bedroom. On my bed is a picture of my daughter. It's been there for 2.5 years. And on my bedside table is her urn. No mother should ever have to come home and see that. Our kids are supposed to be with us, and they're supposed to outlive us. They're supposed to outlive them. I'm now unable to move because I have her bedroom the same way as it always has been, and I never want to change it, because it's all I have left besides memories, but at least that's the only concrete thing I have left. So please, if you're ever upset or and thinking that it's the only way. It's not the only way. I would do anything to have my daughter back. Thank you.
I truly hope the content in this video helped any individual out there who's struggling by giving them some perspective. When I say that my messages are always open, I truly mean that. You can shoot me a DM on Instagram or send me a message on Snapchat, and I'm here to listen to you rant and just get things out that you've been bottling up. I may not be a licensed therapist, but I'm here to help you get any professional help you may need in order to keep you alive. Mental illness isn't something that goes away. And because it is an illness, it's something that you do have to live with. But with the right help and the right supports, it makes it easier to do so. Honestly, the signs I would say to watch out for, although a lot of people do say isolation, you also have to check out on your friends who are the happiest as well. I know Robin Williams has a quote out there that mentions that the happiest people tend to be the saddest people with a mask on, because they know what it's like to feel upset and they just do their best to make sure everyone else is happy. Honestly, I want to get the message out there to check in on your friends, on your family. Say I love you whenever you can, because you never know when someone's going to be out of your life. But I truly hope this video brings awareness to suicide and prevents people out there from taking that action. I want to thank everyone I reached out to and talked to in regards to this video. Whether you participated or not, it means so much that you gave time to me to help out other opportunities, gave me some numbers of other people you think would be interested, and I wanted to say that my thoughts are with all the families, friends, anyone who's been affected by these individuals' passings. Thank you so much for watching this video, to those of you who participated, and to anyone that's helped me along my journey, and to anyone that's helped anyone else through someone else's as well. Be there for each other. Be kind to one another. Everyone deserves to be here. You feel your heart? That's your purpose. You're left. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to keep going with the flow, sailing through your days, and seeing where life takes you.